After the execution of Charles I, England was a republic. Look at what happened to the design of the Great Seal, the official mark on statutes and proclamations. Here's Charles's seal, the seal of a king. He canters on horseback with his greyhound running alongside, and the Latin motto means Charles, by the grace of God, King of Great Britain, France and Scotland, Defender of the Faith. After his execution, the new republic was in theory ruled by the House of Commons. So instead of a king's seal, the Great Seal was the seal of the House of Commons. It shows the Commonwealth, a map of Britain. And on the other side are the Commons themselves. And the motto simply says, 1651, in the third year of freedom, by God's blessing restored. In English. Didn't last, though, because the real power wasn't the House of Commons. It was the army. For a while, the army was too busy to take much notice of England. It was occupied with the destruction of Ireland, where a large part of the population were irredeemably loyal to Catholicism and the monarchy. But when it finally turned round and looked at England, it found that there still hadn't been a thoroughgoing Puritan revolution. So, in 1653, Cromwell, the army's most powerful general, cleared the Commons at sword point and installed a new parliament, which he thought would be more capable of bringing about a revolutionary transformation of society. His own Chamber of Righteous Puritans, the so-called nominated parliament, turned out to be no more to his liking, and he dismissed that too, installing himself as the Lord Protector. And the Great Seal was now his own. It shows Oliver Cromwell on horseback, just like Charles, but stepping out very stately rather than cantering with a greyhound. And the motto says,
by the grace of God, the Republic of England, Scotland and Ireland, and the Protector Oliver.
In Latin. In what sense was this a republic? However unwillingly, and he kept protesting his unwillingness, Cromwell was driven by his own belief in the divine right of revolution to run the country as a militarized kingdom for Puritan saints. There were now 11 districts, each run not by the people, but by major generals. These military ayatollahs collected taxes, ran the courts, and controlled public morality. Theatres were closed, along with brothels and gambling dens. Horse racing and cockfights were banned. Everyone had to go to church, stay sober and morally upright. Pagan festivities, like Christmas, were banned. Mince pies were forbidden. Oh, it must have been great. In 1656, a newly elected parliament made it clear they wanted to return to the old constitution. They reopened the House of Lords and offered Cromwell the title of king. He seriously considered it. And although he turned it down, perhaps because the army would have turned against him, 2 years later, on his deathbed, he nominated his eldest surviving son as his successor, like any other king.